Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to Mr. 3D. In this video, we are going to take a look at CankTOS Procedural Materials Library, which is made available, of course, by CankTOS. It's an ever-growing library of procedural materials for Blender. It comes with a staggering 180 materials. And not only that, most of the materials comes with enormous amount of customizable parameters. Using those parameters, you can create thousands of unique versions of materials which you can save as presets without filling up your hard drive, like you would with image textures. As these materials are procedural, they only take few tens of megabytes and does not fill up your hard drive. With that being said, we are gonna dive into Blender and take a look at it. I'm using my custom theme. It's one of the themes from my True Dark themes pack. If you are interested in getting it, the link is going to be in the description. Now we are going to install the add-on. So go over to Edit, Preferences, under Add-ons, and install the add-on that you have downloaded from Blender Market. And you can also install the Asset Browser version of the materials library as well. Once you've done this, just save preferences and then close preferences. This is my setup to demonstrate to you how this add-on works. Now, where to find your materials? If you press N on your keyboard, and you can see that we have a new panel popped up right here. If you click on it, and then you will see the panel with materials. So here we have a bunch of categories you can choose from. Each category has its own materials. So the one I want to go with is the buildings, and we are gonna choose the ground material. Now I already applied a ground material. And if you go into camera view by pressing numpad 0, you can already see the quality of it. So if you go over to material properties tab, you can see that we have bunch of values that we can change in order to create a unique material. And you can play around with these values. You can create hundreds of unique versions of this material. Before we start tweaking this, we have to actually enable displacement because it's flat. So in order to add a displacement, first you need to understand a small and a unique feature of this add-on. Now I'm gonna zoom in a bit just so you can see properly. There are icons to help identify a few things about materials. The color green, yellow and red is for the processing time. If a render engine is recommended, they have a letter E for EV and C for cycles. If the material works in both render engines, it will have no letters. And if the material needs displacement, the icon has dents. You can see that it requires displacement. If you select your plane and go over to render properties tab, under cycles, you have to change the feature set to experimental from sported. From there, you need to go all the way down here under subdivisions and change it to 1 pixels. The lower the value, the better the result is going to be. And I recommend you go with like 4 to 5 for viewport because it's gonna make it a bit slower, but you can set your render value to 1. It will render at maximum subdivisions, so you will have a better result. Now go over to modifiers tab, and while your floor is selected or the object to which you have your material on, then add a new modifier, subdivision surface, and change it to simple, and also enable adaptive subdivision. Make sure to leave them on default, and then go over to camera view, and you can see that it still looks flat, and that's because we have to change one thing in the materials panel. Go all the way down here under settings, and then you will see an option from bump only to displacement only. Now once you select it, you can see that it's actually displacing and making it look real. And if you go out of camera view, and you can see that it looks pretty good, and you can see the depth right here. So this is how it works. Now when we have set up everything, you can go over to the materials panel, and you can see a bunch of settings to play around with. So you can see the tile width and the tile depth. So if we increase the depth, you can see that we are increasing the number of tiles here by using this. Then we have tiles profile. So if we go into camera view and then change the tiles profile somewhere around maybe the one you like the most, and you can see the difference it's making. Then you have some tiles color. So if you change the color, you can see it's affecting the tiles like this. The default one is good. Then we have tiles color variation. You can customize to your liking and get the most results out of it. Now, I don't want to go through all of these parameters because I want to make this video as short as possible. So I will just show you some of these, like mortar size, which is the distance from one tile to another. And if you increase this, you can see that the tile size is decreasing. And we have some water level to play with. So if you want something more, you can add. It's just gonna make it a bit higher. So depending on what you want, you can always change to your liking, as I've mentioned before. You can also add mud and dust. You will have a noise. You can also see the option to change the corners of the tiles. So if you want them to be rounder, you can increase it to 1 and you can see that. Then you have noise profile, how much destroyed you want them to be. This looks pretty cool. Make it like here and just change some of these values like this. You also have the option to increase the height just like that, maybe more if you want to. It depends what you want. Then we have tile roughness. You can always make them shinier, make them rough so that they won't, you know, make any reflections or all that stuff. Then we have some displacement and bump options and also a random seed. So if you change it and it will just continue to place some random variations of the material. We can also increase the damage of the ground and we can increase the intensity of the damage as well. Then you have some ground uneven and ground height. You have to play with all these to get what you want, and if you like the result, you can save it as a copy like that and just rename it. Now let's take a look at some other materials. So if we go into camera view and then change to something like sci-fi panels, let's take a look at them. These also look pretty cool. Then you have some roof tiles. Then we have some ceramic hex tiles, which is awesome to have. Right now the scene lights are way too high, so that's why we are not seeing the results perfectly. And then you have profile, like, so you have to play around with those settings and take a look at them. And yeah, then we are going to take a look at some stones. Let's say we want some marble. Let's add that marble in. Then we have some other stone materials. So if we assign them, and these look pretty cool too. Then we have some more stones like granite. You can take a look at them. These are awesome as well. Some marble. If a copy already exists of the same material that you have previously added to your scene, it will ask you if you want to add a new copy or you want to assign an existing material. So I'm gonna go ahead and assign existing material. That's pretty cool. So we are gonna take a look at another scene file in which we can demonstrate more materials. Now I have opened a different scene and you can see that we have some kind of cloth, and we are going to take a look at some cloth materials. So if we go over to fabrics, and then you will see a bunch of materials here. So the one I want to use is this one. So if you click and assign it, you can see that it looks pretty cool. One thing we also have to do is to change it to simple, this mesh to which we have our material on, and then also enable adaptive subdivision. And you can see that this looks awesome. And you can see all this gap right here. You have a bunch of settings to play around with. You can make it even or uneven, decrease the gaps like this, or you can increase the gaps to 1. There are a bunch of settings that you can play around with and make your own unique materials. Now take a look at some leather materials like this one. So if we select it and assign it, you can see that also looks pretty good. And then you can see some more leather materials like this. Then we have some superhero materials like superhero hex cloth, and you can, you know, apply it to any superhero costume, which is awesome to have this. We have some more with some different stuff here. Now we are going to take a look at some other materials. So for that, I'm gonna open up a new scene. Here you can see that we have our marble material and it looks pretty cool. And you can just simply change to whatever material you want. So for this, I'm gonna go with the food first. In the foods, we have chocolate materials and they all use displacement. So if I apply a chocolate material, you can see that we have pretty nice stuff. And we can also take a look at some synthetic materials, which are some car paints, plastic, and some rubber, all that stuff. So let's just take a look at car paint, and this looks awesome. And you have some settings you can change and get the results that you want. Maybe this one and all that. You can add grain, you can remove all the stuff, you can blend in, play around with and have fun. Then you can go over to some plastic materials like maybe this one. Yeah, assign this, and this looks awesome, man. You can add some glass materials as well. Now the lights in my scene are pretty intense. Now I can show you some of the glass materials. You have Arcvis glass materials, maybe this one. This looks nice. Then we have some these. All of these glass materials are different, so you can have fun playing around with them, and you can also just play around with these values to get what you want. Then we have some toon shaders, and these are pretty cool to see. More like water. So if you want water, you can add some rainy window. You can apply this material to windows and have these water droplets on them, and you can just simply control some sliders here. We have caustics, then we have rain shader. The good thing about rain shader, it's animated. So if you apply this on a plane mesh, you will see how it looks like this. If I play now, you can see some droplets forming around here, which makes it more interesting. Now back to rendered mode, and you can take a look at some other stuff. Like we have some navy materials right here, then we have cardboard materials and also some glossy paint. We also have foam materials. You can separately apply them on top of another material and tweak the values. And then we have some iridescent material, and it's awesome. You can increase the iridescent intensity, animation, roughness, or make them shiny, and then the scale, then the blend, all the stuff. Then we have some soap bubble material. So if you apply on it, and it will look like a bubble, which is awesome. I love it. I'm probably gonna be using this in my future renders, so make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you won't miss any of my future videos. You can take a look at more materials from the creator of this materials pack. I'm gonna put the link in the description. And yeah, that's it for this video. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section below. And of course, if you like this video or you learned something from this, you can go ahead and give a like. And don't forget to share it with your friends. And if you're new here, it's gonna be amazing for you to hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.